Donald Trump was interviewed by Dan Bongino. And a number of different topics came up. One was the state of the pandemic under President Biden. And Trump had an interesting way of thinking about that.
Well, first of all, could you imagine if I were president right now and we had this massive attack from the coronavirus? You know, now they like to call it the, they have new names and they'll have other new names, but it's exactly what we had. We had the same thing. If that were me, they'd be saying, what a horrible thing, what a horrible job. I don't ever hear that, you know, and these are numbers in some cases that are equivalent to what it was, but we don't hear that. I think this.
Okay, so first of all, Francesca, he brings up a good point. Can you imagine if under his presidency, we had been hit by a coronavirus? I think it's a coronavirus. I think he said it was a coronavirus. Imagine if one of those hit during his presidency.
Oh, wow, that'd be crazy.
Can you imagine that?
What? You're so dumb. I just want to squeeze his little brain. You're so dumb. What is inside of this? It's just a ball of lint. Oh, it disintegrated in my ear. So stupid.
I don't know what. And look, him saying that deranged, lint-brained thing that he said is bad enough. But Dan Bongino, he powered through. He's not going to ask some sort of follow-up. He's not. I don't even know if he noticed. I'm like, should I give him the benefit of the doubt and say that he thought, what the hell are you talking about? Maybe he didn't. Maybe it just went right by his dome. I don't know. But that seems
very,
like the sort of thing.
That's very difficult for anything to get by Dan Bongino's dome.
It takes space.
Let's be real.
If you have been saying, you know what the problem with Biden is? Cognitive decline. If you've been saying that, okay. Be a guy that's worried about the mental state of politicians. There's material out there. You can do that if you want. But then you can't have an interview with Lint Brain and not bring up when he pretends that the coronavirus didn't exist. Now, there are a couple of other issues. One, they're not talking about the numbers. What are you talking about? Like, I can only speak for the damage report, but we talk about it constantly. I know it probably bothers a lot of our audience. Nobody watches those videos, but we do talk about it. The thing is, though, when talking about the numbers, you do get to talk a little bit about what are we trying to do? What is the person in charge trying to do? 100,000 cases under one president who doesn't even admit that it exists and says it's gonna magically disappear or whatever is slightly different than 100,000 cases under another president who is trying to get literally everyone vaccinated and is being stymied at every turn by the very governors of the states that are leading the rise in those numbers. Mm-hmm. That's what I just exercised is barely critical thinking, but they don't even do that. Anyway, now,
what's his follow up? What's his follow up?
There wasn't one. Follow up.
Right.
There was consequences though. So that's not the most important part of that. And we're gonna have to gloss over this, but he also talked, the president did, with Dan Bongino about election fraud. And he talked about how the election had been stolen. But if you were watching in the replay, you might not have seen that. As Liz Harrington noted, she said, wow. So I went to post a clip from President Trump's great interview from Fox News last night, and lo and behold, Fox News edited and changed what President Trump said, censoring out 45 accurately describing the fake election. First of all, they didn't change what he said. They just edited it out. They didn't put in fake words, but they did cut out the section where he talked about election fraud. Now that led to, on Parler and a bunch of other right wing things, Dan Bongino being slammed as part of the mainstream media. He's censoring the president. He's pretending the election was fair, which he is not going to let stand. So he posted, I was not made aware of any edits made to my interview with President Trump on the Fox News YouTube account. I'm looking into this right now and I will provide a full account of what happened. Well, what happened was that they edited it. We don't need a Capitol Commission. They were worried that he was going to get them in legal liability, so they edited it out. That's what happened. So anyway, he doesn't want you to think he's part of the mainstream media, but the issue with that, Francesca, is he does work for Fox and these people now hate Fox. So how do you, that's a weird position to be in.
I will have a strong words for my employer. Boop-a-doop, masks are bad. What? Was I supposed to follow it? I'm mad. I'm still mad. Anyway, I'm gonna just collect my check here. Like, Bongino, man, this guy, he got a break. He got a break to get on Fox News. Took him off of Facebook. You know, I miss the old Dan. You know, Dan was just a real, he shot from the hip when he was on Facebook. Also just shot, I'm sure, generally into the air and around.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.